we continue with oscillations. In the last lecture, we learnt that what an oscillation is, and we learnt that oscillations of a system can take place only about a position of stable equilibrium. We also learnt the characteristics of a simple harmonic motion, that is, the acceleration of the system is proportional to the displacement and is in direction opposite to the displacement. And now we shall apply these concepts to do examples, and then we shall go on to see how two or more simple harmonic oscillations can be combined. Now, we have springs which are arranged like this, two massless springs of constant K1 and K2. This is called a series arrangement. As you can see, they are in series. In this case, there is just one force which is stretching both the springs. And if Y1 and Y2 are the displacements of the two springs, then the total displacement is Y equal to Y1 plus Y2. And if K effective is the spring constant, then the force by spring, the effective K is equal to force by K1 equal to force by K2. So that 1 by K effective is 1 by K1 plus 1 by K2. That is, if the springs are in series, this is how you get the effective spring constant. You see, we just added the displacements and substitute the values of y, y1 and y2, which is f by k effective equal to f by k1 equal to f by k2, and from this we get 1 by k effective is equal to this. And now we substitute the values and find the time period in this case is 2 pi m into k1 plus k2 by k1 by k2. The same two springs can be arranged like this. This is called parallel arrangement, and we have already seen that in parallel arrangement, the two spring constants get added. The effective spring constant is the sum of k1 plus k2, and the time period is 2 pi m by k1 plus k2. Suppose that the Earth is a homogeneous sphere of radius r. Remember that we are talking of homogeneous Earth, Earth which has the same composition throughout. This is not true of the actual Earth, but we assume that it is the same. So, the Earth is homogeneous sphere of radius r, and we again drill a hole, straight hole through the center of the Earth, and then we shoot a particle of mass m through it. Let us see what happens to this particle. When this particle is at a distance y from the center, that is at the distance y, then what happens? This sphere, this dotted line shown, this sphere has a mass, and this mass would attract this particle back to the center of the Earth, right? So, let it be a distance y from the center at a certain instant of time. At that point, it experiences gravitational force from the mass of the spring of radius I. The mass of the sphere of radius y is my, 4 pi by 3 rho y cubed, as you know. The force on m is force g m m y by 1 by y squared, again Newton's law of gravitation, and m y I substitute from this, and I get f the force equal to g m into 4 pi by 3 rho y. So, that is the force which this particle at a distance y is experiencing downwards. Remember that y is upwards, the force it experiences is downwards. So, that is our problem. Since it experiences a force which is downwards and the displacement is upwards, and then the acceleration f by m is proportional to the displacement y. So, this is a simple harmonic motion. The rest is simple calculation, and you can show that the time period t is equal to 2 pi square root of r by g, where g is the value of the acceleration due to gravity at the surface of the Earth. We have introduced that g equal to g m by r squared to simplify things. So, the time period now is 2 pi square root of r by g, where r is the radius of the Earth and g is the acceleration due to gravity at the surface of the Earth. And if you substitute these values, you can get the time period. Now, it is possible that a particle or a system is under the influence of two or more simple harmonic motions, as I have shown here. This particle has simple harmonic motion from this spring and simple harmonic motion from this spring, or from this spring or this spring, and we want to see what happens to the particle. Suppose simple harmonic motions are in the same direction, then y1 is a1 sin omega t, that is our equation. Y2 is equal to a2 sin omega t plus theta. We have introduced theta because there may be a phase difference in these two. But if these two oscillations have the same phase, that is theta equal to 0, then y is equal to a sin omega t, y2 is equal to a2 sin omega t, and you get y equal to y1 plus y2, which is a sin omega t, where a is equal to a1 plus a2. The amplitudes have just added up. So, if the two simple harmonic motions are in the same direction, they are in the same phase, they have the same frequency, then the amplitude is simply the sum of the two amplitudes, and the displacement is the sum of these two displacements. We can write the displacement a1 sin omega t plus a2 sin omega t plus theta, if theta is not 0. So, we can now use trigonometry and expand these sine functions and this sine function and collect the coefficients of sin omega t and cos omega t. And then we can write y is equal to a sin omega t cos delta plus cos omega t sin delta, which is a sin omega t plus delta from trigonometry, you know. And what is a? A is the square root of a1 squared plus a2 squared plus 2a1 a2 cosine theta. Remember, this is the way we add vectors. So, if there are two simple harmonic motions of the same frequency but differing in phase by theta, then their amplitudes are added like vectors. So, a1 squared plus a2 squared plus 2a1 a2 cos theta and the square root of that. You see, when the phase difference between the two is theta, then we have displacement equal to a1 sin omega t plus a2 sin omega t plus theta. And now, we use trigonometry. We get y equal to a sin omega t cos delta plus cos omega t sin delta, which we can write as a sin omega t plus delta, where a is the amplitude of the composition of these two simple harmonic motions, and this a is given by a1 squared a2 squared plus 2a1 a2 cos theta. And note that this is as if two vectors have been added. The amplitudes are added up when there is a phase difference of theta as vectors. So, a1 and a2 has been added up as vectors. The phase difference is given by tan delta equal to a2 sin theta by a1 plus a2 cos theta. Remember, this theta is the initial phase difference. So, expanding the sine and cosine functions, you get y equal to a sin omega t plus cos delta plus cos omega t plus into sin delta, and that is a sin omega t plus delta. And a, the important thing to remember is that the amplitude of the composite oscillation is the vector sum of two amplitudes a1 and a2, and the phase now is delta. Tan delta is equal to a2 sin theta by a1 plus a2 cos theta. Remember that theta is the initial displacement, and if theta is equal to pi, then you can see this becomes 0, so delta is 0, and this also becomes minus 2 a1 a2, so a therefore becomes a1 minus a2. If there are two simple harmonic motions with a phase difference of pi, then their amplitudes are simply the difference of the two amplitudes is the amplitude of the composite oscillation. The displacement of a particle varies with time according to the relation y equal to a sin omega t plus b cos omega t. This is the application of what we have done so far. Is the motion SHM? What is its amplitude? You see, these two functions, they differ by a phase factor of pi by 2, and therefore, if we use this formula for a becomes simply root of a square plus b square, as the phase difference in between the two functions is pi by 2. So, this is simple harmonic motion, and the amplitude is the square root of a square plus b square. Now, I think this amplitude is a1, this amplitude is a2, and we have seen that they are added like vectors. So, if you know this, then this is the resultant amplitude. If there are more than two, then you find the resultant of a1 and a2, which is this green line, and then this and a3, which is this brown line. So, we can keep on adding a large number of simple harmonic motions and find their amplitude by simply applying the vector sum. Now, let us take simple harmonic motions which are perpendicular to each other. That is, x is equal to Ax sin omega t plus theta in the x direction and y equal to Ay sin omega t in the y direction. So, one oscillation is like this, another oscillation is like this. What happens to the composite of these two oscillations? Again, suppose theta is 0, then we have Ax sin omega t, Ay sin omega t. We can divide one by the other, we will get y by x equal to Ay by Ax, which is the equation of a straight line, and the slope of the straight line is Ay by Ax. So, the composition of these two is a straight line, and the slope of this straight line is Ay by Ax. So, the path of the system under the influence of two perpendicular simple harmonic motions in the same phase is a straight line. Is the motion oscillatory? Let us see. Let R be the displacement along the straight line. Then R is equal to x square plus y square under root. You see, this R is x square plus y square under root. And if you substitute the values of Ax square, x and y, you will get Ax square plus Ay squared into sin omega t. So, it is R 0 sin omega t. That means, the oscillation, the resulting oscillation is simple harmonic motion. If the phase difference between the two vibrations is pi instead of 0, then you can easily see that the line now, straight line now would be like this. Its slope has changed from a y by a x to a y by minus a x. I show you together here, x equal to a x sin omega t and y is equal to a y sin omega t. When phase is 0, phase difference is 0, then straight line oscillation is like this. And here, when theta is pi, the resulting oscillation is like this. One can take the phase difference pi by 2, and you can again use trigonometry, and you can get x square by a x square plus y squared by a y squared equal to 1. You see, you use sin squared plus cosine squared equal to 1. So, you can get this x squared by a x squared. X squared by a x squared is sin squared, and if the phase difference is theta equal to pi by 2, then this is cos. So, it is cos squared plus sin squared. So, x square by a x squared plus y squared by a y squared is equal to sin squared omega t plus cos squared omega t, which is 1. So, this is the equation of an ellipse. So, the composite motion is an ellipse. If this ellipse lies between the a x, this half of its radius is a x and half of this radius is a y. So, this lies in this rectangle. And if the phase difference is pi by 2 and the amplitudes are equal, then you find that this ellipse becomes a circle. You see, if a x is equal to a y, then you have x square plus r square plus y square by r square equal to 1, which is the equation of a circle. So, this ellipse becomes a circle. And if is any general phase difference theta, then you can again use trigonometry, x equal to a x sin omega t plus theta, you combine it with y equal to a y sin omega t, and you will get this equation, x square by a x square plus y square by a y squared minus 2 x y a x y into cos theta. This is the equation of again an ellipse as shown here. This is the equation of an ellipse. So, when two perpendicular simple harmonic motions are combined, then the general motion is an ellipse. In a particular case where Ax is equal to Ay, it becomes a circle. And all these figures, this figure, these figures are known as Lissajou figures. And in many science parks, like one we have in NCRT, you can see there will be arrangement of pendulums perpendicular or in the same direction, and you can get by giving them a certain phase difference, you can get different Lissajou figures by giving them different amplitudes and so on. The concept of simple harmonic motions is used in most areas of science. However, it is an idealization. The system oscillates with a single frequency independent of amplitude, but no oscillation in nature is perfectly simple harmonic motion. Although oscillations of pendulums, spring mass systems and LCR circuits and acoustical systems are very nearly simple harmonic motion, but they are nearly simple harmonic. They are not actually simple harmonic. Simple harmonic is an idealization. In the next lecture, we will continue with oscillations and we shall study what are known as damped oscillations, that is, oscillations in which the amplitude keeps on decreasing and slowly the system comes to rest. And forced oscillations, where the system is forced by a periodic force so that the amplitudes continue. The oscillations are maintained by a force. Those are called forced oscillations. So, we shall see what damped oscillations are and what forced oscillations are, and we shall see their characteristics.